Hi, it's Rachel, and in this episode, I'm going to show you how to make KDP covers with Canva for beginners.
All right, so I'm going to show you how to create this. This is created in Canva. It is with all free elements, and you can upload this to KDP. The only thing I want to say as a precursor to this is make sure that you have the right usage rights when using any elements from Canva, and if in doubt, you can email Canva directly and ask them about usage rights for sites like KDP and Print On Demand eBooks. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to have to do is you're going to go to KDP Cover Calculator. And I'm going to have a link to that down here below, but basically you fill in all this information about the eBook that you're creating. Make sure you've already created that eBook because this is very specific to the type of the size, the number of pages that your eBook is. So if you have the interior of your eBook all ready to go and you just need the exterior cover, then this is where you go to get the proper measurements for that. So you pick paper book or hard cover. I'm doing paper book, black and white interior, premium colors, standard colors. You pick the one that is relevant to your book. Most people pick white paper, but again, it's up to you. Page turn direction, standards left to right. Measurements, make sure you pick inches. And interior trim size. So this is where you pick the size of the book. Again, it has to match whatever your interior is already. If your papers or your pages are already in 5x8 or 8x10, then you have to pick that one. I'm gonna pick the 6x9. And then how many pages are actually in your ebook? So the number of pages formats the number of trim sizes. So then the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to click the calculate dimensions, and it's going to give you the dimensions of your ebook. Now, what I like to do here is download the template. So I click the download button, download the template, because we're going to upload that template into Canva. But to create our Canva document, we're going to use these numbers right here, the full cover size, just these numbers. That's the only thing that's important to us for this step. So we're going to go over to Canva and we're going to create a design. We're going to click the custom size. We're going to make sure we are in inches, and we're going to input those numbers from over here. So the width and the height, 12.52, 9.25, that's what we have in here. We're going to create a new design. Okay, now once that document is loaded, you are going to go to your uploads button and you're going to upload that file that you just downloaded from the KDP cover calculator. You're going to upload the PNG of it, and you just click the upload button. Once you have that file uploaded, you're going to add it to your document and you're going to measure it out, expand it so it matches your document perfectly. The next thing I want you to do is go to file and go show rulers and guides, and then you're going to pull these guide lines over and you're going to match them up just after the red part. And I do that for all the red parts in here. Okay, and why I'm doing that, that just shows me where I have to keep my design elements in. Now this is not the background, but the different words and phrases. So it will say it right on here. The red area, your background artwork must fill the red area, but do not place logos, text, essential background images in the red area. If your artwork does not meet the requirements, it may be rejected. So this is the only thing, I put these guidelines here so I make sure that my artwork, like my text and my images, are within this area. Okay. So then the next thing that I like to do is add a square. Oh, and I'm going to just put it over here on the barcode, because again, this is an area that I do not want to add any images to. And then the third thing I like to do is add another square. And this is going to help me center everything later. So I make that square to match those grid lines. And that's just going to be there for a guide for later. Okay. Now you can get rid of this background. You do not need this anymore, and then we can start designing. All right, the first thing I like to do is go down here in my elements tab, and I like to add a grid, a full page grid. And I just want to make sure that this is the same size as my artwork. No point in any bleeding or anything because this artwork already has the bleed included in it. So I'm going to create that alphabet practice worksheet. And how I'm going to do that is I just searched in elements for chalkboard, and I searched with a price of free, And I just found the chalkboard down here. This is the one that I found. And then I just pull that in and fill in the whole page. So it's filling in all the bleed and everything. You can get creative with this and decide if you want something on one half of the page or whatever you like, but this is how we're going to do this one. Okay, what you need to do first is you need to lock this background. Otherwise, when you add other elements in, it's going to replace this background. So we're going to click the lock button twice, and then we're going to be able to add in the elements. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is find the graphics. So I typed in classroom. Again, I searched it on free items, and I scrolled down and I found this cute little banner here. So I'm going to add that in. I'm going to resize that and put it up here. I can see that it's centered now with this device, so that's going to help me keep it centered on the front of the ebook cover. The next thing that I want to do is add some text. So I'm just going to click the T button on my keyboard, and that's automatically going to add a text box here. And I'm going to write in the alphabet practice sheets. And I'm going to change that text to, I found this cute little text, the Bore Soak text. Again, it's a free text that you can get in Canva. Make sure that all of it changes to Bore Soak, and I'm going to increase that size to about 56. Okay, and again, I'm going to take this text and center it. I might need to do some centering at the end, but I can do this and click on the text and click on position and click on center, so that will center to that box. Okay, then I want to change the colors. So I'm going to highlight the color of this first word, and I'm going to use the colors from my banner. So I'm going to make that one blue, and I'm going to make this one purple, and I'm going to make this one blue. And you can make it any colors that you want. You can even change each individual letter, which is pretty cool. And then the last thing that I want to do is I want to go to this magic recommendations and see all, and I found some more clay art, and you can add all kinds of different things here. I add this in the original one, but I kind of like these little workbench here, and maybe I'll add a little flower to that workbench because that's pretty cute. And you can do whatever you think will look really pretty in there. So now you have a completed design. You're going to delete all these other items, and you can remove the rulers and guides, and then you have the completed design. So then the last thing that you're going to need to do is you're going to need to export this, and you want to export it or download it as a PDF, and you want to use the PDF for print. And you don't want the crop marks and bleed, but you want to flatten your PDF. And RGB, that would be for digital use, but if you are doing print on demand, you want the CMYK to be chosen. That's pretty cool that they've added that. That's new. And then just click download, and you will have that item downloaded, and then you can upload that into your KDP program to have that cover for your artwork. You don't have to worry about any of the other elements in here. It's going to pre-populate like your ISBN number when you upload that into KDP. But that is how you create a KDP cover with Canva for beginners and for free. Right, remember to like and follow and subscribe to this channel so that I can create more great videos for you.